Hi everybody, welcome back to Cucina Divino, benvenuti a tutti. It's been a couple of weeks since we've been on, but things have been a little hectic, but we're getting back to normal, so we're going to start our dinner tonight. We're going to travel to the Tuscany region of Italy tonight. That's around Florence and that area, known for their meats and wild game and food. We don't have any wild game tonight, but we're going to be using chicken. But we have a special guest tonight. Our grandson Michael is visiting from Long Island, and he's come down to visit, and he's quite a chef himself, or a cook himself, and he's brought some of his recipes with him. So he's gonna, this is his, and we're gonna try a chicken dish. So Michael, come on in here.
Sure.
Say hello.
Hello everybody, how's it going?
And so why don't you explain what we're gonna be doing tonight. We're gonna make a Tuscan chicken.
Mm-hmm.
Tuscan chicken, pollo alla Toscana. And we're gonna get that going. So just some simple ingredients, right? We're gonna use about a half an onion, sweet onion. We have three cloves of garlic. We have a tomato that we've chopped up. We have, how much is this? About a half a cup of Parmesan cheese. We're gonna use some fresh spinach, which we've washed. Gonna use, for starters, a cup of heavy cream. And of course, some salt, pepper, and what'd you add, a special thing here?
A little bit of paprika.
A little paprika tonight.
Just a little more flavor.
I'm gonna add that. And our chicken. So we have chicken breast, and we've just sliced that. So, let me get started with this. I'm gonna take some of our olive oil, right?
Put it in the pan, and I'll start salt and peppering the chicken
okay,
a little
bit. Okay, you do that while I'm doing this.
Sure.
How much oil do you wanna put in here?
Just to coat the bottom of the pan a little bit, that's all.
I'll turn these over for you.
Yeah, great, I don't like those sticky hands. Just a little paprika, not too much. Just like that. All right, give me a flip.
Oops.
Yes. Thanks.
This is good. All I have to do is watch.
Yeah, you got the easy part. All right, and a little paprika on both.
Okay, looks interesting.
Thanks. What do you say we head over to the pan and drop these in, brown both sides?
Yep.
Yeah.
Great. Okay, let's go. You want to bring that over?
Sure.
Here's your tongs.
Thank you.
All right, we have our oil, olive oil in the pan. We have it on a low, medium.
Sure, it's hot. Not quite ready yet.
That's okay, you can put them in there.
All right.
It'll get hot. Yeah, it'll start to go. Squeeze that guy in there.
Yeah, perfect.
Yeah, just
and
perfect.
We got everybody in the tub.
All right, so. All right. Explain. So now what are we going to do? We're going to put these in here for about how long?
About 2-3 minutes aside until it's nice and brown. We're going to flip them over.
Right.
And then we'll take them out from there.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we'll do that. And that should take about 2-3 minutes, 4 minutes or so. And we'll be back. Okay. Looks like chicken's been, maybe 5 minutes going in our pan. Jerry, you want to get a close-up of that? It looks nicely browned. Looks good. We're ready to take our chicken out.
Yep, looks pretty good. I think we can take them out.
Go ahead, Michael. Take
one
out.
At a time here, yep. Yeah. All right, now at this point, gonna make sure we're on medium heat, okay? We're gonna add in our onions here.
Yep.
Thanks.
Oh, yes.
Thanks. We'll add our tomatoes. That's enough. Stir it around a little bit, and finally the garlic, okay?
Spoon.
Yeah. So we'll just stir this around and give it about 2 minutes, just until the onions get soft. Don't want to burn anything here. All right. So you can see, if you look in the pan here, right, our onions and tomatoes got nice and soft, and we're ready to add the spinach. So what I'm going to do is about 2 handfuls of this at a time, because you're going to see it's going to really wilt down. All right. So let's go with 2. We'll stir this in, and it's going to get smaller really quick here.
So we're going to do this in a couple of batches.
Yep.
All right.
So this one should go kind of fast. Kind of want to get the onions and tomatoes on top of it. Helps it wilt a little bit. Okay. See, already.
Yeah.
It's reducing, right?
Halfway already.
Yeah. A couple more stirs and we can add at least another handful, maybe 2.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, let's put the other handfuls in and then we'll be back in, what, a couple of minutes?
Yeah, about 2 minutes.
Okay.
Right. All right, so as you can see, all that spinach we put in, if you can see here, right, it's reduced down completely by at least a quarter, I'd say, right?
Yeah, right.
So we're ready to add our 1 cup of cream. So I'm going to put that in slow here.
Yeah, I'll take that.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, we'll just stir that in, and we're going to let that simmer for 1 to 2 minutes. So we'll be right back after that. All right, so you can see the cream starting to bubble up a little bit. Okay, so what we're ready to do is add our cheese. It's about 1/4 cup, and we'll just sprinkle it in.
Now, I guess you could use a pecorino cheese if you want a stronger flavor.
Of course, yeah.
Yeah, this is Parmesan.
Just gonna give that a stir. And I'm gonna add a little bit more salt and pepper just at the end here. Not too much.
Pepper's good.
Looks good. Okay. We'll give it a stir again. Not even 30 seconds here, okay? Just get it all mixed in. All right, it looks like we're ready to add our chicken back to the pan. I have our cooked chicken from before. All right.
I want those juices too.
Sure. Okay. I'll let that simmer for another 30 seconds again, and we're ready to serve. I like to put a little spinach on top, you know, get it all mixed in together, just like that. Okay. I'll heat the chicken through again because it has been resting. All right, we're just about ready to serve.
You ready? Done? Okay,
yeah.
So we shut this off?
Me. Sure, shut it off, right?
Shut it off, turn off the power here.
Great.
And,
come over here to the counter. I like to put one nice piece on the bottom of the plate here. And a little bit extra on top, just for serving. Hey, this would also go great with pasta if you have, or of course some bread on the side is always perfect, right?
Yeah, it looks good. Yep.
All right, here we go.
Maybe some angel hair pasta.
Put this in the sink if you want to put the parsley on.
Oh, you could garnish it with a little parsley. And there we go.
What about some sauce?
There we go. We could put some sauce on here too, right?
Of course, yeah.
Looking good. All right. Are we going to do the taste test?
I guess we should dig in. Want to do the honors?
Right. All right, let me do the honors of cutting.
All right. Get a little bit of everything on there.
All right, cheers.
Cheers.
Tasted good.
Very good.
Very good.
Mm. Perfectly cooked, tender.
I like that.
Oh yeah. Very nice.
Did a tomato.
Pretty good.
Yeah, good recipe.
Not
excellent. Ottimo, as they say in Italian. The best. So, hope you tried this dish. Not too bad, just a few ingredients. It didn't take long to make. We're here for about 20 minutes making this. And thanks to Michael for coming down.
Anytime.
And thanks for sharing the recipe. And we'll see what other stuff you have up your sleeve.
Sounds good.
So until next time, everybody, ciao. Tutti a mangiare, tutti a tavola. Ciao.